So this is the final video for forging a Zweihander. This is right after heat treat and temper, and as you can tell, it's not snapping, so it's at least spring tempered now. Now I'm just doing some very rough profile grinding, getting out all the waves in the blade, which I probably should have done before heat treat, but oh well. And also getting rid of the scale for belt grinding. Decided I wanted some kind of harsh shoulders on the transition from non-blade to blade. Learned on this side that it's a lot quicker just to cut off some chunks rather than trying to just grind out all of it. I just keep spraying it down to keep it from overheating because I don't want to overheat the blade at all, just being real careful. And doing some filing off, profile filing on the pairing hooks to get a more consistent curvature to the inside of the hooks, since can't really get in there very well with the angle grinder and definitely can't get in there with the belt grinder. Lots of filing. Good thing it wasn't hardened at all. Here grinding a convex grind on the whole thing, basically giving it a lenticular cross section just to keep as much rigidity in the blade as possible. And on to the hand sanding of the blade. Start with 60 grit, then 120, then 220, 400, and then 1000 grit. Onto grinding the guard, making it flat and cleaning up the sides. Cleaning up the rings, trying to get them flat and even. Just make it easier doing it here rather than while it's all attached. And arc welding them together. There's a lot of pinholes in these welds, so I went over it multiple times, and we ended up deciding on blackening the guard just so those pinholes wouldn't be as apparent. It looks better that way anyways. I'm filing the welds to just smooth out the transition between the weld and the base metal, so hopefully that it looks like it's one piece and not three pieces welded together. Having a piece of hickory and just chiseling out the channel on one half of it and doing it to another piece of hickory and then gluing them together. Some rough handle profiling. Thank you. just grind out that channel. And rolling the pommel together. And now putting a bevel on the pommel. And filing the hole for the tang on the pommel. To reduce that gap. Here's rough assembly. Off camera, we blackened it. Kind of forgot to film that, but oh well. And forgot to film sewing this up, but you can see it's just a sewn up piece of leather. Saran wrap on the sword to prevent it from rusting, because I'm gonna be putting on the piece of leather, wetting it, and putting something with some weight on top of it so that it'll form to the shape of the sword. Time to glue up the leather to the handle, and using wax string, compress the leather onto the wood while the wood glue dries, and ended up using about 80 yards of string. Probably took about an hour to wrap it all up, and afterwards I unwrap it after everything dries. Just gives it a nice texture. Put epoxy on the tang, so there's another form of security, fills up all the voids. in the handle, even though it's a pretty tight fit. And finally, peen over the tang.